Folks, good news and bad news. People in Hawaii live longer than any other place in the country. That's good news.
The bad news is they could be targets for scams. Kirk Matthews has more.
Our seniors live longer and they are more active, but they may become the victims of scammers and con artists.
Seniors tend to have saved up a nest egg, so they tend to have more money readily available. Also because of that, they're probably going to own their own property, they're going to have good credit, and that in itself makes them a good target.
Newman says there's a reason why our kupuna may be easy targets. They grew up in a time where trust was a given.
People were probably more trusting, so there's a belief that people like that could potentially be more easily victimized. Also, seniors are often ashamed to come forward if they have been victimized. They don't want family members to believe that they're incapable of taking care of themselves.
And it may be that seniors are not thoroughly familiar with the technology that may have been used to dupe them. Newman says there's a variety of scams that can take seniors in.
Different variations of the lottery scam continue to be very, very popular. There's the variation where you get an email or a letter that says you've won, but in order to release the funds, you need to pay certain fees, you need to pay some taxes, so they're trying to get you to send money.
Scammers go to Facebook to find out about relatives, then send a fake email posing as a grandchild stranded in a foreign country asking for money. Medicare can be a pitfall for seniors who get a call asking for their checking account number for a number of fake reasons. Family members should watch for red flags. For instance, the senior becomes more secretive or says they expect to come into some money soon.
And they're going to be able to help out more. So any of those things could be red flags that something has happened. And it then just goes to starting the conversation.
Communication is the key. Kirk Matthews, KHON2 News.